Amen. Thank you, Jim. As I had mentioned last Sunday, it was just a terrific trip. It was just a great trip. Safety all the way around, beautiful drive down and drive back, gorgeous weather pretty much the whole week. Had a little bit of rain one evening. Other than that, it was low 80s, high 70s. The kids worked hard. The adults were amazing. I want to thank the sponsors again. Obviously, without you, it'd be extremely difficult to pull this off. Thank you, parents, for trusting us with your kids. Thank you, leaders. We have the best leaders. Katie and Josh, as I mentioned this morning, are youth ministers in their own right. I believe they may be, maybe they'll take over when I'm gone. Not sure how long or how old they'll be when I'm 80. But Donna was amazing. She fixed all of our meals, took part in helping with getting the social calendar and going and keeping that on track. She handled the finances, which is a big deal with my math skills. So much appreciative of Donna. And Rhonda and Jerry were with us primarily to watch after, help with watching Henry, but they did so much more than that, so much more than that. And obviously, as I mentioned this morning, last week I spent a great deal of time bragging on Jim. As difficult as that was, it's hard for me to try to do that again. But Jim, all kidding aside, was an amazing addition to our crew. I mean, he was involved, engaged, volunteered to participate in everything, which is far beyond what I do. I'm not necessarily very participatory when it comes, for instance, to getting in the water to go down sliding rock. That water's just so cold, and that's just always been a real weakness. I remember a few years ago, I was in the dunk tank for Burgoo, and the air temperature was like 45 degrees, and it was a miserable thing. Again, the kids were just incredible. They work hard. They stay on task. They were good with the children. They were, by and large, good with one another. You know what it's like to spend a lot of time with anyone for any length of time. And they were really good. They all got along for the most part. And we're just very, you should be very grateful and thankful for the youth that we seem to always consistently have really strong mission trip kids. When we go out to feed the homeless and work with the homeless, oftentimes during the summer they go with me and they just get right in there and they engage, they speak, they interact. When we go to Scarlett's Bakery, they enjoy being a part of that. We'll be doing some of that when I get back from my trip that I'll be taking this next weekend. I'm doing a mission trip with my wife to Pensacola, Florida. So your prayers, you can even sponsor us. We'll do a little video to show you. Okay, kids, come on up. They're going to say a few things. A couple of kids. Monty, you can start. And then after that, when Jim speaks, we'll have a video.
Jim, I know you helped me and hope with us, and I know you helped me meeting that coffee and all stuff, and you see me all right and all that stuff. Thank you, Jim.
For those of you who are unaware of what he was saying, everything was all about Jim. It was every single bit was about Jim. So it was really neat to see their interaction and bonding. They went on lots of walks, drank coffee together. It was really, really sweet, quite honestly.
morning. I just wanted to start off by thanking you all as a church for sponsoring and supporting us. This trip is such a great experience that I enjoy going on every year. This year was all about living in the now and stop looking for the treasure in your life. You're standing on your X, and you can't rush time, and you can't go back in time. And you should live every moment to the fullest in God's word. I struggle with this a lot. I always wish something would come sooner, or I could go back and change something. Like, I couldn't wait for school to be over, couldn't wait to leave for vacation, and can't wait for senior year to start. It's so easy to start wishing you could go back in time, or wishing something would hurry up and happen. We miss what's happening in the past or present. Reminiscing on the past and wishing you could go back and change it is doing nothing but hurting yourself, and you should just learn from it, not regret it. We used Henry as an example this week. If you watch him, any little thing makes him happy. He finds a rock and he can treat it like a diamond. And Josh said we need to live like Henry. He lives every day like it's Christmas. Loving on those kids this week made me appreciate having the chance to spend a whole week with them. I really tried to live in the now this week, and I've tried to bring it back home with me and appreciate the opportunities I'm given in life. Live on your X. That's your treasure God has given you. Everything is sacred.
Good morning. I had a really fun week in Junaluska. Some things that I did was kayaking and swimming in the pool. Some things that we all did was slide on rocks and putt-putting. We also had a chance to help others. Some of us staying at the playground, other of us got to do yard work. I got to help Miss Tana clean up the bottom of the sink, and I helped with the quilts. I learned a lot. We talked about how our body is a temple of God, how we need to treat it with respect, and be careful what we put in it. My favorite part about it is sliding rocks and sleeping because I love to sleep. I really appreciate my sponsors helping me to get to have an opportunity to go on this trip, and I really appreciate Katie, Daryl, Josh, and other adults who helped us keep us all in line. Thank you, and thank you for my sponsors again.
Amen. Thank you, girls, for sharing about the trip. And Monty, I'll pay you later, okay, for saying those good things about me. But I want to begin by simply thanking the church, again, for your sponsorship, which a lot of times we think of that just in dollars, and we're awful thankful for that, for sure. But you also have been praying and supporting in other ways that I heard about. So I want to thank the church for that. But I also want to thank the church as a whole and the youth group, Daryl and the youth group, for allowing your senior pastor to be away and to be a part of the trip. And I really wanted to be a part of this trip so I could get to know the youth better. Some of the youth I've gotten to know through Bible school and the drama stuff and things like that. But it was really good to get to know all of you to a greater degree. And I was able to do that because of the leaders that we have. And so I want to thank them. Daryl put together a wonderful time of the sessions, a theme entitled Everything is Sacred. And it was very well done. In fact, he's talked about maybe even doing this as a four-week study or sometime for the adults as well. It was done well. Josh and Katie really put together a lot of things that happened both in the sessions and on the work site. And I think you guys were actually over the work site and the leadership there. And Donna Hamill, I have to say, she's the logistics coordinator. I got to spend a lot of time with Donna because I rode down with her in her car following or ahead of the bus. We have to leave Daryl because he doesn't know the way now, right, to Junaluska, I think. She said, somebody always has to lead there. No, but that's good because he's got other things. It's true. And so rode both there and back. But she was gone while we were working at the community center. Donna was often the one out somewhere buying the supplies, getting lunches ready. So I really thank her for that as well. And then Rhonda and Jerry, as you've heard, they did a lot more than just watch Henry, but that really freed up Josh and Katie to be fully a part of the trip. And I have to thank my buddy Monty, because Monty helped hold me accountable. He and I went on long walks together in the morning sometimes or in the evening. And that was good for me because the food at Lake Junaluska is absolutely wonderful. And there's a lot of food. And so I'm so thankful to kind of told him this morning, kind of missed my walk with you, yeah. You know, during the week. So that was wonderful. Thank Caitlin for serving as one of the table leaders as well. But the biggest joy I had was watching the young people here on the front row, just to be able to serve other kids. And they just served with all their hearts. Some helped organize the food pantry. Then you heard a few of the things that you guys did as well. They interacted great with the children. The children at this community center, it's a center that used to be a school. It's got a lot of age on it. Basically, it was closed as a school. This community group bought it in order to help, really help serve children through the summer and after school, an after school program. And so all the kids there were, what grade? Probably our age is about 5 to 12 or so. Does that sound about right? They were kind of elementary age, and they're doing a wonderful job with them. But to see the young people talk with them at lunchtime and share, go into the classrooms and play games with them, help do the staining. A lot of the group stained the new playground equipment that was outside, and it was great to be able to do that. And that for, the equipment looked a lot better, but the best part of the fun was seeing those children come out and get on the playground equipment and start using it. One of the things these guys enjoyed doing was getting in the seesaw. You'll see it on the video. There was a seesaw boat that three or four kids could sit on each side. And those kids just wanted the guys and the girls to push them as hard as they could to see how. And those guys are practicing now. But it was just great to see your interaction. On Wednesday, I guess it was a field day. Was a field day going to one of the national parks near Cherokee. We went with the children as part of that. And then the group organized and led all the games on a field day. And they had all kinds of fun events, and you'll see that in the video as well. So I just enjoyed it. I didn't have to be concerned about what's coming next. That was Daryl's job and Katie and Josh, because they have the program. And so I just got to be a part. And that really was good for me. I got to go down rock slide twice. You'll see evidence. I thought after the second time, I better not show up with a broken ankle. I'll have to explain that to Culture Marvel, so I stopped it two times. But I enjoyed that time. I enjoyed putt-putt, you'll see. And my team, there's my team right there on the end of the row, our foursome, Zachariah, Micah, and Price. And there were some priceless moments during the trip, pun intended, some priceless moments. But I really appreciate Zach. Now, I'm not competitive at all, but Zach and I were tied after like the 12th hole in putt-putt. And I noticed he was kind of mumbling a little, and he goes, "I don't guess I should pray that my pastor missed this putt, you know." And but I prayed him down anyway and went on to the victory. You can see the trophy in my office. No, I'm just kidding about that. But we had a great time. But I really did appreciate that. And Zach, man, anything to get you to pray, okay? We'll pray. We can play putt-putt. But most of all, it helped to teach me what Daryl was teaching, that we need to take each moment God gives us and live in the present. As one of the girls said very well, it's easy to want to look ahead and see, you know, high school's finishing, so forth, and look back, and to really miss the present. And that's what a lot of the lessons were about. And the order of the day, at 7:30, we ate breakfast. At 9 o'clock, we were over doing the sessions. There were 8 different sessions about everything is sacred. And then we'd go work till about 3 and some free time and be back for a night session as well. So it was a long day. But the part of the session I enjoyed was day 2, which was called waking up. And how do you wake up each day? It's highly important. How do you start your day? And Daryl kind of emphasized how we start our day will either form the day in a good way, or it'll be a malformed day if we're not careful. And oftentimes, I've been just as guilty as anyone else, we start the day, the first thing we do, how many reach for the cell phone, you know, to check something real quick, and pretty soon you're checking the news, you're checking, and oftentimes the first thing we do in the day is that, or just hurry as fast as we can to get to work or to get to school to get ready. And so some of the teaching was on the spiritual disciplines, the spiritual habits, even if it's a few verses that you read to begin your morning, to let that be the imprint for the day upon your soul, and you can build on that time as you start it with God, with Jesus Christ. And part of that was remembering our baptism and the wonderful words of Jesus, the affirmation he received from his Father. This is my Son, we say son and daughter for us, whom I love, and in him I'm well pleased. And to remember as we wake up that we are loved by God, and to develop these habits that get the day not only started with us in the Lord, but then we can minister and be on mission wherever we're at for God. One of the things I was impressed with, I don't think I might have had the courage to do this, but Daryl, one day he just wanted the group to enjoy Junaluska and the swimming, the boating, and just nature, God's nature itself. And, you know, a lot of we're on the phone. So one afternoon he said, okay, for free time, all the phones are going into our room, room 26. And I want you out there just enjoying the beauty of nature and God. And so we had all those phones. I think I took a picture of them. While the kids were out having fun, we were answering all their texts back, you know, to, sorry, I can't go out with you this. No, we did not do that. We did not do that. But that was enjoyable. I saw the kids on the lake and walking and just enjoying God and one another. So thank you. But you guys, it was fun. It's been fun to do it again. Monty's invited me back for next year, so I hope to go back. And one thing I would like to share, I went 42 years ago. I was 15 years old, and I went as a youth delegate from Gadsden Street to a conference called the Southeastern Jurisdiction Volunteers in Mission. I didn't know what I was getting into. I just said yes to the pastor, myself, and another young lady. And we picked up youth all the way along in a minivan or in a big van going up to Lake Junaluska. I saw the place I stayed. But to realize the prevenient grace of God, I was at that camp of Volunteers in Mission. And at the age of 23, on a Volunteers in Mission trip, my life was radically changed in a deep conversion experience and a call to be in mission for Jesus Christ. And that mission has continued ever since. I don't want it to be 42 years before I get back to Junaluska. And in fact, how old would I be? I might could still make that in 42 years. But anyway, if you get a chance to go there, it's wonderful. But we love you guys. Thank y'all for all you share.
Thank you all so much, Jim. Thank you so very much. It's so much, well, anyway, I was going to say something, I'll wait. We're getting ready to watch a video that Katie has made for us. And I alluded to the fact that one thing that I didn't worry about this week was, I wonder how the video is going to turn out. Or I wonder if she's working hard on it. I wonder if she's putting the right things in or using the right music. I didn't even think about the video. When it came to be game night and Josh had was in control of that, I had no worries whatsoever. With the food, with the finances, all the things that Donna took care of, I just literally never worried about it. When Jim was engaged in being a part of it, it's really neat when you have that kind of leadership, when you can just let go and just not worry about it. And that's just a neat thing. So with that said, here's a wonderful video that Katie has put together for us.
Freedom was something I never found. I'm trying to find 6 feet on the ground. Under the weight of all of my sin, fighting the fight that I couldn't win. And you rescued me, and now I can breathe. I was a dead man walking until I was a man walking with you. I was a blind man falling until I found the light. You're calling me to pull me out of the darkness and pull me out of the lies.
I do not deserve a thing, but that's just who you are. I was a dead man walking until I was a man.
In my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know.
Oh, me that it all belongs, that everything is sacred. I eat the bread and drink the wine, but help me love my neighbor and show me how to hold this life. Cause I don't want to waste it. No, I don't want to waste it. Oh, heaven is upside down. It can be here and now. Oh, seeing it all around, that everything is sacred. The ordinary shines and glows, filled with your intentions, and you don't see between secular and sacred. Oh, show me how to hold this light. Cause I don't wanna waste it. No, I don't wanna waste it. Oh, heaven is upside down.
Seeing it all around.
I asked this question this morning. How many of you have had your picture taken with that cross? Look around. These are memories that will last these young folks decades, just like some of you can look back over the decades and the years. The memories that they have made, the friendships that they've established and culminated, the spiritual things they've learned, the things they've learned about each other, about themselves, they'll take these things with them on into their future. We're thankful that you have invested, not just with your finances, but with your time and your prayers. We're so very thankful that you support them the way you do, and that those 12 minutes, those are some precious minutes to give you an idea of just what they experience as a result of your support. Thank you again. Jim?
Amen. We do want to thank Katie again. She did a great job putting together that video, and Josh and I were talking. That's not easy to do. That takes a lot of time to put together a video like that, so we're very thankful for her, and but great to see you guys, and great to see you on the front row. How about next Sunday? Front row? Yeah, right here. Justin's going back to the... going back to the back. All right, but wonderful young people. Thank you all again for sharing. The altar is open for any needs you have. If you want to just come and pray about the kids learned about where treasured possession, X marks the spot. Right now is an important time to be in mission. If you want to pray about that yourself, you're welcome to come. If you don't know Christ as your Savior and Lord, well, we'd love to introduce you to Jesus as we stand and sing our last song today as Tom leads us now. Oh, nope, as Pam leads us, actually. Pam, that...